The earliest evidence for the domestication of dogs can be found in Europe some 36,000 years ago. The Levant later sees domestication 13,000 years ago, while in Asia, evidence can be found for domestication at least 33,000 years ago. In this time, the comparatively standard wolf coat has given way to a vast range of unique pigmentation in domestic dogs. This has caused many geneticists to ponder, what are the genetics of pigmentation in dogs that has allowed such diversity? Thanks to over 100 years of research into mammal coloration, including that of famous geneticist Cyril Wright, we have deduced the two responsible pigments, eumelanin and pheomelanin. Eumelanin can express colors ranging from light brown to black, while pheomelanin can express colors ranging from cream to dark red. Both pigments have complex production pathways with a variety of involved enzymes. Studies have shown that mutations along their respective production pathways explain some of the variation in colors expressed by both pigments. Let's now take a look at a dog hair to see how this coloration takes place. At the base of each hair are cells called melanocytes. These cells are like pigment factories and can pump out either eumelanin or pheomelanin, coloring the hairs located above them. On the surface of these pigment factories is the melanocortin 1 receptor. The melanocortin 1 receptor, often shortened to MC1R, can receive signals from one of two molecules, which tells the melanocyte which pigment to produce. Melanocyte-stimulating hormone, or MSH, is continuously produced in the skin and brain of canines. When it binds to MC1R, it will induce eumelanin production in the pigment factories known as melanocytes. Conversely, the dermal papilla cells, located nearby to the melanocytes, are responsible for making agouti signaling protein, or ACIP. If ACIP is present, it will always be dominant over MSH and induce pheomelanin production. Located deep within canine chromosome 15 is the gene encoding the melanocortin 1 receptor. Previous studies have shown that if a mutation occurs within this gene that stops the receptor from passing on signals to its melanocyte, the cell will simply produce pheomelanin by default. Such mutations are responsible for the coat colours of the golden retriever, undoubtedly the cutest dog breed. Such mutations in the MC1R gene, as well as similar mutations in the ACIP gene, have been the focus of most studies into dog pigmentation. However, it wasn't until a team at the UC Davis School of Veterinary Medicine expanded the search that the genetics of complex pigmentation could truly be explained. In this 2021 paper, the researchers compared whole genome sequences from domestic dogs of five recognized phenotypes: dominant yellow, shaded yellow, agouti, black saddle, and black back. They would then compare these genomes at the ACIP loci for each of the phenotypes, quantifying differences in the DNA sequence of each. By doing this, they were able to identify what differences in DNA sequence were associated with a yellow coat, and what differences were associated with a black coat. They did not find any association with differences in the protein coding region, but they did isolate two highly associated promoter regions upstream of the gene. Promoter regions are responsible for the strength of protein expression, and given ACIP is responsible for shifting melanocytes from eumelanin production to pheomelanin production, it makes sense that the amount of ACIP present would determine the strength of this shift. The two promoter regions they isolated were the ventral promoter, which controls ACIP expression on the underside of dogs, and the hair cycle promoter, which controls ACIP expression on the top of dogs. In comparing the ACIP loci of dogs from the five pigmentation patterns, the researchers isolated two ventral promoter variants and five hair cycle promoter variants. Each promoter variant had differences in the DNA sequence, mostly polynucleotide expansions and sign insertions, while the lesions are observed in hair cycle promoter 3 and 4. Due to these differences, each promoter was of different strength in expressing ACIP, and given ACIP binds dominantly over MSH, stronger strength promoters were dominant over lower strength promoters. Meaning, if a puppy received ventral promoter 1 from mum and ventral promoter 2 from dad, mum's copy would be expressed. The researchers could now associate each dog colour pattern with a haplotype of the ventral and hair cycle promoters. For example, a haplotype of ventral promoter 1 and hair cycle promoter 1 gives a dominant yellow pattern, as both promoters are strong ACIP expressors, while a dog with a haplotype consisting of ventral promoter 1 and hair cycle promoter 3, which induces no ACIB expression, would be expected to have a black saddle pattern. To test these new predictive haplotypes, they took skin samples from 366 dogs, sequenced the haplotype, and recorded whether it matched what they expected based on the observed coat pattern. Sure enough, in 352 of the 366 dogs sequenced, a perfect correlation was observed.